Hello, my name is Bonnie. I thought I would share a little bit about myself while you guys see me attempt to make a Native American basket. I got this little kit at one of our local thrift stores. I love thrifting, and I thought it was pretty cool and something I haven't done before. So I tried something new, which I always try and do when I'm creating art. But anyways, a little about myself. I'm from Kansas, here in the middle of the U.S. I have a degree in metalsmithing and jewelry design from Kansas State University. I'm currently going back to school, getting a little extra education so I can hopefully in the future be an art teacher, because I think that would be so fun. Let's see, a little bit of how I got onto the idea of teaching. I started teaching Chinese kids to speak English online, and that was so fun, and I got to meet so many cool kids, and I never thought that's something I'd want to do, but I gave it a shot and I really liked it. And then that got me on to being a substitute teacher in my kids' school district, which is challenging, but it is awesome in its own way. And those two things right there gave me the ability to stop working in the pharmacy. I'd been there for a long time. And if any of you work in the medical field or in a pharmacy or heck, even retail, you know, it's super stressful and busy. So leaving that job was very hard because I'd made so many friends, but it was better for myself and my family without that stress in there. So I did that and I was subbing and having a good time. And then with some nudging from some people and finding out that it's possible to go back to school and add on a teaching degree, well, not teaching degree, teaching license to my degree in essence. And so that's what I'm currently doing. I'm having a great time. I'm going to Bethany College in Lindsberg, Kansas, and it's super awesome. They're great people over there. So let's get back to this video a little bit. So I started off my basket, and it's a coil method of basket. And so I have two paper rods, basically cores, that I am sewing together with raffia, which I've never made this before, and it hurt my fingers. Holy cow. My fingers were so sore. I worked on this basket for almost a week straight for hours every day. That's half the reason why you're not going to hear anything from the video. We're just going to listen to some nice music and me talking and see how it goes. It just shows me going and going. And you can see all of that paper core there that I'm using. So it just keeps going. I also want to talk about the fact of if you get a basket like this from somebody, holy cow, if they made it for you, they like you. It takes so many hours and hours to do this. Or if you go somewhere and you see baskets like this for sale and you think, gosh, those are real expensive, there's a reason. I mean, it's very time consuming. And especially to get your pattern just perfect. I had a little bit of a struggle with that. You can see here, I'm starting to put the black in there to show my pattern. I also wanted to do this basket because here in Kansas where we live, there are Native Americans here. I grew up in dancing and there were Native Americans in my dance group. And I always thought that their artwork is beautiful. You know, they do all different kinds of things. And we grew up going to Colorado and seeing different indigenous people things there. And there was a place outside Estes Park that we used to go. And I believe his name was Charlie Lightfoot, I believe. I'm sure my mom will correct me if I'm wrong. And he would make different leather goods and we'd go and buy them. And I remember getting different jewelry with turquoise and different stones, and he would tell us stories. And it was always so great to hear the stories because they're so different from what we heard. And he was always a really nice person. I am not proficient in making baskets. I just wanted to give it a try. Just something for myself. You see my design there. I originally wanted to do a different design, but I decided doing straight lines are hard enough. And thinking about the outside shape of the basket. It's a little wild and crazy. I want to also say I appreciate everybody that's seen my other videos. I'm planning on trying to make a video every week. That's a little tricky with my job and kids and school and everything. Oh, I forgot to mention, I do have 3 boys. They are wild and crazy. Keeps my day interesting. So this is just showing I'm keep going, adding on the sides. And this is me finishing it. You have to trim it a certain way so it can kind of blend in. And I left this whole part in here so you could see how you have to stitch each one of these through. And the hard part is you have to stitch and make your needle go in between the rods of the previous row at the top. And there's 3 in there and it's a little tricky and makes my fingers hurt. So here it goes. Just making it go through, make it look nice because, you know, craftsmanship is key. If you don't make it look nice, then why bother doing it? Yep. Alright, it's getting down to the end now. Let's see, I'm finishing it up with a couple extra stitches. And then you stitch down into the next row a couple times to kind of seal it in and hide everything because we gotta make it look nice. And then here is the final product. I thought that it turned out pretty great for my first try. You know, it's pretty good. And then here at the end is a little bonus footage I'm going to show you of my cat Maple being naughty when I was trying to make this. She was my friend the whole time I was making these. It was pretty funny. She's half Maine Coon, half Tabby, and she's a ball of fire. She likes to pick on her other cat, Ike. It's pretty funny. So, yeah, she likes to chew, and I'm telling her, no, no, get off the table, come on. And she says, these are my playthings. All right. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. I'll see you next time. Bye.